Hi everybody, sorry this video is late. My fault, I've been travelling, I've been to Kenya with the Ladies European Tour and, well, it's the manufacturer's fault because they've been bringing out so many new products that us at Golfalot have been really busy at the beginning of this year. However, I felt like this video needs to come out. The golfing season in the Northern Hemisphere is fast approaching. If you want a new set of irons, check these out, because I tested pretty much everything out there and I suppose you lot don't have time, so let me run you through my best of for 2021. Thanks once again for always supporting us at Golfalot and stay tuned for some more content for the rest of the year.
Golfalot's best improvement irons of 2021, the ultimate feel better about your game iron, the ones that save you when you hit that one low off the face. I've narrowed it down to six. I'm going to put them in categories and give you my best performance iron of 2021. But before we start this video, please click the like button, the subscribe button, because we want you to follow our journey and watch as much content as possible. Put a lot of hard work into these videos and it's all for you guys, so you can pick the best club for your game. And in this case, it's the improvement, the game improvement irons. So how am I going to review these irons? I've looked back at all my reviews over this past year, so the iron had to be out in 2021, and I've split them into categories. First of all, looks and feel, then forgiveness, distance, and value for money. There are six irons: Ping G425, Callaway Apex DCB, Titleist T300s, TaylorMade Sim2 Max, Cobra Radspeed, and TaylorMade P790. Now, the two TaylorMades in that top six, but I've been saying this for a long time, I really do feel like P790 stretches across the majority of the spectrum of golfers, and especially game improvement irons. You can find out all the specs of the golf clubs that I am reviewing in this video in the comments below. Looks and feel. Now, this was an area that manufacturers didn't look too much into before. It was all about distance when it came to performance irons. But in the last couple of years, they've had to, because we want the best of both worlds. So number one, TaylorMade P790 and Callaway DCB. No shock there, it's a forged iron. Titleist T300s, Ping G425, Cobra Radspeed, and TaylorMade Sim2 at the bottom. Now, it's bookended, isn't it, with the two TaylorMades? So you can see why that happens. The P790, they're trying to make it look like a blade. The shelf appeal is right up there. The generation three they're on now, I think they've got better and better. They've almost done as much as they can with the technology. They need to make it look good. The Radspeed, I mean, it's quick, it's quite, it's hot, you barely feel it on the face. That's why I've not given too much in terms of looks and feels. Those two bottom ones actually are quite thick in the head, whereas the other four are slightly thinner as well. So in terms of feel, I think Ping sits number four there, but I want to give them a special shout out for their wedges. I do think that they have really worked hard on their wedges, and it's not like a shovel compared to a Sim2. It's a lot more playable around the green. Forgiveness, number one, Ping G425. I think Ping are the most forgiving clubs on the market in all areas, really. Number two, TaylorMade Sim2 and Callaway DCB, Cobra Radspeed, Titleist T300s and TaylorMade P790s come in at number six. Now, I looked at, on my TrackMan, the difference between my best and my worst carry, average ball speeds, and you want to get everything as close as possible, and that's what makes the consistency the best, and that's why G425 sat on top with my six iron in my testing with the G425. 297 RPM variance in spin, whereas with a T300, it was 862. Now, you've got to be careful of this with performance irons, because everybody says, oh, it spins too low, that's why it goes so far, etc., etc. If you can keep your spin numbers really consistent and close together from the first shot to the last shot, your dispersion in terms of length, short and long, will be better. So that's always something to keep your eye on. And ball speed. If you can keep your ball speed similar, that means that wherever you hit it on the face, so with the G425, it was 1.8 difference, 1.3 in a DCB. It got up in the P790 to 2.1. Okay, that's mile per hour. So there's only a little bit here and there, but that's what put me P790 ball speed. The difference was a bit too much. So that's why it's gone last. So that's a little bit complicated, but I do feel like in now with the performance irons, even though I'm going to go on to distance, it's not all about distance. It's making your bad shots better. And that's why I put G425 at the top of the list. Distance. Now, Cobra Radspeed came out on top. These were a joke. There was like the Mavericks that Callaway did last year, really, really hot off the face. You barely felt them. It was like the club was doing it for you. Next up, TaylorMade Sim 2. Then TaylorMade P790, which someone would be surprised at being at number 3. But I really like these P790s. They get me a bit giddy. And I think sometimes that extra 10% of love for them does make you hit them further. But that's something to be quite wary of if you are going, oh, that looks like a blade. They're still pretty hot. Next up is a Titleist T300, then Callaway Apex DCB, and then Ping G425. Now, 6 iron carry, my maximum on the testing was only 150 yards, where with the TaylorMades, they were 160 yards. So there's that club difference in them. I really didn't feel like the G425s were hot, silly hot. The lofts aren't jacked as much as the others. It's more of a, we've given you this club if you're changing from maybe a 10 handicapper and above, you can use the G425. We're not giving you another option. We think this iron caters from 10 handicap to beginner, where the other manufacturers chuck in a couple more. So I think that's why it's not as strong lofted or as hot as the Sim 2 Max. Value for money. Now, this is 4 iron to pitching wedge on all of the 6 irons. I've put number 1 Ping G425, and that is because of my statement before, how I feel like this caters for a lot of golfers. You know, you can buy these at a 28 handicap and you can progress down the line till you are nearly a single figure handicap, whereas with the Sim 2, absolutely not. I mean, this is kind of 20 handicapper and above. So first, Ping G425. Next, Titleist T300. Now, these are only £896. So when you compare that, it's cheaper, only a couple of quid cheaper than the G425, and it's not that over £1,000 bracket. Now, when I tested the Titleist, obviously, they go 100s, 200s, 300s, 400s. I was thinking when you get into 300s, there's going to be way more technology in them. So the price is going to escalate. And it wasn't the case. These are actually cheaper than the 200s and the 100s. And I think it's because in the irons, the metals change. In order to get them to go further and the technology in them, there's a softer metal in the 100s and the 200s, that forge element, that feel element, that Titleists are almost given away a bit because they need to jack it up with technology. And also, just in my opinion, I think better golfers pay more for their irons because they can feel it more. So yeah, number two is Titleist T300. Next up, Callaway Apex DCB. Now, these are over £1,000, but they're forged. I think that is a significant feeling. Once you start getting better at golf, which these clubs will do, you're going to start feeling the ball a lot more on the face, and forged is going to be, it's going to be a nice ride, trust me. Next up, the Cobra Radspeed, then the TaylorMade Sim 2, and then the TaylorMade P790. Now, I've done that because they're the most expensive club at $1,149, compared that to the Sim 2 Max at $899. Now, okay, there's a price difference there. I'm still going to say go P790, but because it's value for money, that's why it's in that order. P790s are more expensive, they're aimed at the better golfer, and as we've worked out, better golfers pay more money for their irons. Here is the verdict. Now, once again, I'm being a bit complicated with this. So I'm going to start at a P790, which shouldn't really be in this category, but the real reason I put it in, if you're starting golf and you think you're going to get better, okay, so you're new to the game, you might be reasonably young, you know, we're attracting the youngsters, a P790 you can start with as such and you're going to get better with, great, go with that. If you are getting on a bit or have got a bit of injuries or aren't going to play as much golf as you would like, get the Apex DCB, because that will help you with a bit of length as you're not playing as much or losing some distance. The G425 is so close, right? It's just, it doesn't go far enough. And Ping aren't offering that other version, but you can get the lofts cranked a bit on them. There is that option, okay? But Ping have never been that iron that goes, this goes a million miles. And it's a shame, because if it was a bit hotter off the face, it went a bit further, the G425 would knock this category out the ballpark. But I am aware that game improvement, people want that bit more distance. So I'm sorry to kind of not give you a defining answer, but that is my verdict. So there you have it. Game improvement irons 2021. I'm sorry for sitting on the fence, but you know what type of golfer you are. So this will help you, hopefully, to buy your next set of irons. Please subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any content. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you again soon.